today I'm going to be doing a video all about the lip products that I use, kind of like my lip routine, I guess, because it's not just like my favorite lipsticks. It's also like some of the stuff that I like to use on my lips that aren't lipsticks, if that makes sense. So I'm just going to get started with the products. Am I too close to the camera? Okay, I don't want to be like super close to the camera. I'll start with the first thing that I do with my lips, which I actually just got not too long ago, and I am in love with it. My lips are really peely and like they're just really chapped, I guess, because I pick them. I know I shouldn't pick them, but this I just got at CVS and it is amazing. Like, I've never felt my lips like that smooth, and it is Skinny Girl Lip Scrub. I got this like, I forget how much it was. I think it was like $6, $5 or $6. And it is really, it's just like a lip scrub. It smells really minty. And I don't know what it is about it, because I've had lip scrubs before, but they didn't leave my lips moisturized. They would just kind of take off, you know, the excess like an exfoliator is supposed to do, but they wouldn't leave them moisturized or smooth. This, I've never felt my lips that moisturized or smooth afterwards. So that's why I loved it. And I didn't expect it to be like minty. I expected it to be more like a fruity flavor, so it kind of like surprised me. But I mean, I guess it's good that it's minty, since it's like near your mouth. It kind of makes, you know, your mouth smell good, I guess. My second favorite thing, which is like my miracle worker for my lips, before I even had that, I used this. And it's Carmex. And I guess it's for cold sores. I don't know. I never really know if people actually use it for cold sores, because I see people all the time using it. This is just like a little pot of, you know, the chopstick. I guess it's chopstick. I don't know what it is. But it is amazing. I put this on before I go to bed. Like, if my lips are really, really chapped, you know, maybe they're bleeding or something, I put this on at night and I wake up and my lips are, like, better. It's just the most awesome thing ever. It's kind of like an overnight miracle treatment. I don't know why it works or what it does or anything, because, I mean, it's just a normal chopstick. And normal chopstick does not do that for my lips. So I'm absolutely in love with this. I use it all the time. Every night, if I remember, I use it. I think it's like $2 or something. The smell, it has like a medicinal smell. I don't really know how to explain it, but it's not like overwhelming. Like, once it's on your lips, you can smell it for like a little bit, but then it just goes away. Like, it's not overpowering or anything. And I feel like the tub lasts forever, like literally forever. I've had this one like, I don't even know how long, and I use it every single day. And as you can see, it's kind of like dipped in the middle, but it's like not even close to gone. I will start off with my favorite, absolute favorite. I use this every single day. It was in my everyday makeup routine video. It's Makeup Forever Professional Paris, whatever. It's the Aqua Cream in 505, I guess. And I think it's coral or something. I don't know. It doesn't have a name on this, but I remember looking it up online. And it just kind of looks like that. The aqua creams are not necessarily made for your lips. There are a couple shades, this one included, that are for your lips and cheeks. The other ones are for your eyes. And basically, they're just waterproof makeup. And they're absolutely amazing, because I don't know, my lips, they don't keep color for that long. So I think I might try like lip primers or something, but this one stays on forever. And that means that it's a little bit difficult to apply as well. When you apply it, and I've done this before too, if you over apply it, you like, you have to use makeup remover to get it off, because it's just going to blotch up and just looks really weird. So definitely don't over apply this, and it's really difficult to take off if you do, so you know, have makeup remover handy. You know, just be careful. I always use my fingers to apply this, only because I feel like I can get the right amount of product on my lips and also in the right places. And I really don't know, because this thing dries really quickly and it's like unmovable after it dries. I don't know how people use brushes with this, because it literally dries almost instantly as it goes on your lips. But I mean, I guess you can use a brush with this. I've seen reviews on it where they use brushes, so I guess that's possible, but I don't. And that is a little bit more on the expensive side. I think it was like $22, but I really want to get another one. Like I said, I always, always, always use this one, but I always use a lip color on top of it, just because I feel like it just gives like a really pretty, like this color will give like a really pretty, like sparkly kind of, I don't know, like nude color underneath any lipstick I use. So I always use one over top of it. And these are my three favorites. This is NYX's Strawberry Milk, and it's like a really pretty pink. I like this shade a lot, because unlike the other shades, they just kind of feel like almost like a gloss on your lips. They're like really, really smooth, I guess, which isn't a bad thing, but they just feel like they rub right off. This one doesn't. This one actually adheres to my lips a lot better than the other shades, and I love that. Of course, it has like the NYX smell, but you know, it's not that bad. And then the Jumbo Lip Pencil in Almond, which is like a really pretty nude brownish orange. Really, really pretty. I do find though that I have to blot and, you know, a powder. You know how you like can put powder on your lips through like a tissue and it makes them stay? I have to do that with this or else it'll just come right off. But after I do that, you know, it stays for like the, you know, general amount of time that a lipstick does. But I really do like that. And those were only like, I think they're like $3 or $4 each. Like they're not very expensive. Now this one is like my favorite lipstick ever, but it is really expensive. Like to me, it's really expensive. It was like $20, $22, $25, something like that. It is the NARS Pure Matte Lipstick in Madeira, which I know I'm just butchering the name. It's really pretty and it's like a very, like the nudest lipstick you can possibly get. Like I've seen, you know, pictures of with other girls where they put it on like really, you know, dense, I guess. And it is really nude. Like it makes you look like a ghost. I like gently glide it over my lips. I don't like, you know, full on lipstick it because then I feel like my lips would just disappear. I just kind of like dab it and then, you know, run it across. Just a really, really pretty nude. My absolute favorite. It's matte. It has no smell, no taste, no anything. It's just a really good lipstick. But, you know, it is pricey, but it's NARS. And last but not least, I hate lip glosses. I don't know why. I just hate them. They seem to pull my lipstick off, and they also move my lipstick into, like, the lines of my lips. And I'm not, like, older. I don't have, like, wrinkles or lips, you know, like that kind of thing that I have to worry about that, but it does that. I don't know why. So I stick away from lip glosses. So I picked up the Color Reach Balm. Because I was like, oh, that's such a pretty color. Well, it turned out it had like absolutely no like color to it on my lips, at least. It looks really pretty on my hand, but when it goes on my lips, it's like there's no color. So instead of, you know, returning it or just like throwing it in my makeup collection to get lost forever, I decided to use it as a lipstick substitute. Because it is extremely smooth feeling. It's so buttery. It has the most amazing feeling ever. Like more than the lip butters, the Revlon lip butters. This just feels so good. And it smells really nice and just like, I like everything about it except for the pigmentation. So I use it as a gloss and I'm using it actually right now over, I forget which color I used, but I think it was a different lipstick. I think it was like a MAC lipstick, but this is just an amazing lip gloss substitute and I love this. I think it was like $7, I'm not sure. And it doesn't even have that kind of like, sometimes lipsticks get sticky after a while. It doesn't do that at all. It just kind of like disappears and fades. And it lasts for, I would say, about 3 hours on me. And this is color, I forgot to say, 118 in Pink Satin. That is all the stuff that I use on my lips, kind of my lip routine, I guess. And yeah, I wasn't going to go through all my favorite lipsticks because I have like a bunch. Because every time I see a new nude lipstick, I like have to get it. So that would be like an hour long video. But thank you guys so much for watching and I will talk to you guys later. Bye. Oh, and in case you're wondering about my background, because it changes every single time and I'm not like mixing up recordings. Like it's not like I taped a recording, you know, last week I uploaded that and then I'm uploading a recording from weeks ago and like it's not like that. I literally keep rearranging my room. I want it to be a little bit, I don't know, like nicer, cleaner looking, I guess. But it's not working very well. And the table that you're sitting on right now was over there, so the rack is like where you are right now. But the lighting over there sucked horribly, so I had to move it. So that's why, you know, that's right there. My bed's like directly behind it. So this is not how my room is normally. I just need a bigger room, I guess. I don't know. Probably not.